So yeah, we got quite far on our first playthrough, I believe. We got through the entire first section. We're on like the second section now. I'm quite a way into it. And we're just starting to do puzzles where we are combining light colours together. We just did the sacrificial temple last off. So now we're going to go into Basilica? Pronunciations aren't great. You know what I'm like with pronunciations, guys. Alrighty then. So, first things first, as always, let's look for our hidden things. Got two energy orbs to find. One more left on there. So we got some rather sneaky looking secret things to activate here as well. The aggregator. Forces buried in the ground that are able to conquer all obstacles. So yeah, we have interesting. What's going on, Kong Clan? How you doing tonight, my man? Welcome, welcome. Can we, so this is a game called Archaica, Path of Light. I've had this for quite a while, just never got around to playing it. So yeah, basically a light-based puzzle, reflecting and combining mirrors together and different bits and pieces. Vaults of the Order of Light. Fourth keystone has been unlocked. The hidden level passage is open. To play, select the active point on the world map. Yeah, more laser games, but this one we don't have pits of snakes where we have to go over. Yeah, exactly. Also, we're missing an energy orb. Where could you be? There you are, hidden away. So it's kind of weird that basically, yeah, you've got the... You'll activate crystals, in short, and... So with this one... For example, we do something like this. I think we're going to want to reflect this over to this one. Oh, we need to get the purple into there as well. So... So we get two purples, but with three mirrors. I'm thinking we're possibly going to want to do... something with this one. If almost we could, like, hit this... from there, possibly. Yeah. And then... I would say we're going to do this. And this. There we go. Yeah, no snake pits in this one. No weird mechanics to find out. Very, very much more consistent, for sure. Right, onto the library. This is like the second area. We started playing this on Tuesday night, I believe, last Tuesday. So there's kind of like a... You kind of get like a nice little break in between. So there's like... it's almost like a like hidden objects kind of thing. As well as that like main puzzle. So you can actually kind of take a bit of a break from the puzzle if you need to, and find all these like hidden bits and pieces which unlock different type bits and pieces throughout the game. So we got the first two before. With the fortress fallen and the gate overrun, the only possibility of retreat, possible retreat through the underground labyrinth, the god's light was ordered as the curtain fell to reveal a stage full of darkness. All right. It seems like the story is kind of told in scriptures kind of thing. Which is a little bit different. At least I can kind of understand the story in this one. I had no idea what the story was about in Lumina, I'll be honest. It was a real struggle. So what we got here? So we got purple, but this time purple is being made with... Okay, so that's connected to that. Okay, it's got the... Okay, so we got the two-way laser thing going here. But then we're going to need to do... What exactly? Do we maybe angle these off at the same... So we're going to have to use both of these, I would assume. So that one's not connected to one of these, so we have to actually hit this with both the blue. So yeah, that needs hitting with the blue and the orange laser, both of them. But then the blue laser also needs to come down here. So what? I kind of feel like, just for 10 bits, Conklin. Thank you. See, that would do that and that would do that. I mean, we could do that to there. Potentially that to there. But that has no... So, I mean, we'd still need orange to hit there. Maybe we can do that, though, instead. But then we'd still need to hit that, right? Problem creeps in. We can... So the one on the top has to have light beams going through it. So we can either hit it with both the light beams or combine. I think combining it's probably going to be the better and more sensible option. So having like something like this. Obviously doing that will then... counter that, so that's not helpful. It's kind of like why I would think you would need something like this, but doing this... kind of nullifies that. That would also need to go there. And by the same account, we don't then have a blue, right? So... So, I mean, that's a thing we could do. But then, obviously, we're still missing that first bit. Ham, 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 ham. All right, so what if I did try to do it the other way, potentially? So what if I did that? What if I did this? That's just going to point the wrong way there, isn't it? Yeah. Not helpful at all. definitely the closest I've been, though, is like this setup over here. That's not in line with each other, so we can't like put a diagonal through one of these and one of those. None of these are really in diagonal lines, so that kind of stops us from doing anything fancy with any of these bits, really. See, that's the problem I have, is that none of these are really lining up in a diagonal. See, I think this has got to hit 2 points, whether it be like two of these or... It would make absolute sense for that to do that. Might we need to take a first hint here? So it's definitely not an option to just like use these angled lasers here like this, because if we do that, we can't then use anything else like that. Could be an option to do something like this. All right, we cheesed it, kind of, is the best way I can freaking describe it. All right, so we only have Labyrinth left. Realm gates. Raised objects markers show the way to the great realms. Only activated when all wells are illuminated. Okay, it's everything found. Is there a way to rotate? I don't think there was there? Huh. So, we don't actually have a great amount of option here. I mean, ideally, we'd want to do that. Did I get a hint of something? I'm confused. I don't know what I'm doing with this hint thing. Maybe I've just messed everything up. Pretty sure we've got to use one of these mirrors here. That's the only useful place that that could be. Gave us something. Oh boy. Things just got complicated. Heavy crystals. Some crystals are not easy to be formed, requiring more than one beam to unlock their power. Okay, that's got everything there. All right, but if we need two beams, though, we're going to need to do... It's almost going to need to be like that, isn't it? Yeah, we're going to need to refract it in. And then back out again. That's only the power of one beam, so that's not going to work. But that will. That one will. Okay, so now I need to do pretty much the same thing, but with positions reversed, right? Like that. So now we can go and do the yellow one. The masters relished the power of the light, using it to their advantage. Sacrificial altars were rebuilt into war machines, and songs from the gods became war cries. Two more orbs to find. I don't know, was there a way to re-roll? Everything. Okay, so we got another one of these double crystals. So now I've just got to work out how to... Let's get two beams into this one here. Is clearly a far more optimized approach to this. See, that's not going to work because we lose one of the beams by doing that. Although not necessarily. Then we don't have a way to get this one into here. Still missing this one. That one to there. The beam strength's running out though. That's the problem. Interesting. We've run out of beam strength if we go too far around the board. Yeah, I don't think we can hit this one like this. That's close. There we go. Told you it was close. Called it. Okay. So, just creating a square seems to work. All right, that's fine by me. As the obelisk rises up, the path to the realm of great waters can be found by the one who has solved the labyrinth's puzzle. And we collected absolutely everything. New achievements unlocked. Excellent. New realm access granted. We are heading to the Eternal Islands and the Wharf. So green and red and yellow. Untamed elements dwell in the wild section of the Eternal Islands, the realm left desolate by the invincible water's mystical properties until the path's builders came over. So this music's nice and tranquil, it seems. Luna, a rare artifact which brings light to required places. Okay. It's interesting. Okay, so we need to power this, to power both of these, it seems. Gotcha. The problem we seem to have here Yes, the problem we've got here is how exactly do we do... How exactly do we do this? I'm just wondering, is it possible to... I just wonder if it's possible to like hit this and this with this. I'm looking at the way everything's set out here, it doesn't look like it is possible. Mainly because of the angle, I think. How can I extend? How do I extend this? Wherever we aim this from, we seem to be like one piece short. That one's just always too short, so... Oh, hold on. Can I do this with green instead? No, it looks like it has to be... I don't know if, like, because it was a property of that... Whether or not I could get away with using... But yeah, that's not gonna work. So do both reach the same distance? My inkling still lies though with like, pointing that yellow over to there, but without having those power, that this yellow one has to be powered. And it's not in a diagonal from like the yellow crystal either. So also, my internet seems to be going a bit wacky at the minute. Did I not try that before? I could have sworn I tried that before. Jeez. I feel dumb. I feel very dumb. Torfgar required power needed for the loons to unleash the light. Okay, so I need to activate that one then. But then that one needs to be activated as well. So that does that and that does that. Thank you. And then that one is now running out of power. So that would need to be placed one back to do anything there. Also running out of steam. Yeah, because that's blocking that. So we do need to use one of these here, I think. Okay. Now, we can't use this. Over here. So we need to, I still believe that we need to use this for here and here. And then with the remaining. See, that's blocking all of that. Don't know where I need to put. We need to put two down, definitely. Combining these two don't give us the combined output. which is interesting. Why would I want to use the mirror? The only point of using the mirror here was to illuminate both of these crystals. Can I position that where it'll hit both? It's not looking good. Alright, so if that's doing that, I think we need to angle this off here. See how that would make sense. Thank you. Excuse me, but yeah, without putting that there. I think that has to be one of these. So there are positions. I don't really know what went on there, I'll be honest. That was a massive, massive fluke on my part. Light may have many forms, a precise one must be selected. Thank you. make sense to do something like this. Converter there. And then all that out to there like that.
Yeah, alright.
Okay. I like the like introductions are always getting a relatively simple introductory puzzle when a new mechanic is introduced, which is quite nice. Lighthouse of a Thousand Suns. Riverbeds has risen by the use of light, and a great dam and a lighthouse were erected to help guide the uncharted waters that gave way to the new realms. So what am I doing here? Oh, okay, so I need to duplicate that. So I'm guessing it would be better. But then we're gonna want to split it off. So maybe we need to convert the light so why doesn't that reflect as yellow? Does. So yeah, I've got to do something like this where I reflect it first into the double thing, and then I need to be able to reflect it back over to here. Thank you. But, you know, doing this. I don't then get to reflect it into there, do I? Which is a problem. At least we kind of know what we need to do. Just a case of working out how to do it. Yeah, positioning of like the position of everything is tricky. We basically need something like that. So if we have this like this, we need to have got to be an angle, hasn't it? I'm pretty convinced that needs to be like that, so I just need to work out. How the rest of it goes. See, taking out that 45 degree mirror really kind of messes everything up here. The other avenue would be like this. Of Oblivion. What a great name. Altar of Glory, the stone monuments withhold the paramount truths only to be revealed to those who follow the path. Okay. So that's got to do that and that. Then if we do that, sorry, see my pop filler. If we do that, how do we then hit two of these? Because we don't have the mirror to spare. Okay, I've got to remember about the like multiple angle things. Instead, we do this. Oh, I didn't do the secret bits either. We didn't do the secret bits. Have we missed a cell? So we missed one of the There we go. So I just found the energy cell. Now thank you. There we go. Can't forget those secret bits. So that's finished off. So far, so good. We've finished off all of these extra ones so far. Sinking rock. I'd say these things are pretty easy to find. He says he then can't go and then can't find the extra last crystal. Alright, what do we have to do here? We need yellow. Do we just need the yellow? Yellow already pointing into here would be good. But we only have the one laser, so it's going to make things quite difficult. So yeah, if I had to hazard the guess, that would go there. I just really need that, so there's no kind of none of the extender stuff either. So yeah, I wish I could kind of like bootstrap these blocks. So like once these are active, I could do something like that, and it would just keep it going. But clearly the devs didn't intend for that. So I feel like with this bit now, I need to do something similar to what I did in the original puzzle. Sorry, not the original puzzle, but the last puzzle where... The last puzzle, the puzzle before that. We had to put the yellow into like the mirror for a start. Problem is, we've only got one mirror this time, so that's what makes it difficult to achieve that. Yeah, so doing that doesn't really work unless you put that there. But yeah, then we're just going to be short on numbers there. How would I get green down here, though? Yeah, I've got to use the splitter first, though. I have to use it first. But I don't know how to. Yeah, the reason I had that there though was to, yeah, to do that, achieve that. We've got here Subsonics with the braid of six. how's the stream going, buddy? Was you running some more resi tonight? Yeah, it's I'll warn you, it's a little bit slow here tonight. The puzzles are pretty darn difficult. But hope you are all well. Welcome along, everybody who is raiding with subs, Snipes. Thank you very much for the follow, my friend. Welcome along. Yo, yo, yo! So yeah, everything's... my brain is about mushed on this freaking thing at the minute. We've made pretty good progress tonight, but as for now, everything... it's a different game, so same sort of concept with like the mirrors and like the reflecting of light and stuff, but this is a completely different game. We did finish that god-awful game that we was reviewing last week, thank goodness. Yeah, that was just terrible. Absolutely terrible. At least there's no snakes in a freaking pit to cross in this game. Yeah, this one's a lot more consistent. At least I understand how like the light reflects off the mirrors and stuff in this game. It's a lot more natural. But yeah, it's pretty hard. It's pretty hard. So what if actually, I'm struggling to do that. What if I actually did something like this? What other mirrors have I got here? I was wondering if I could like reflect it back down here, back across, and then to do everything. Talos Principle is such a good game. I absolutely love Talos Principle. It's in there with one of my, it's up there with like my top puzzle games. I do like playing puzzle games. It's like one of, there's probably like the main genre I stream in games, puzzle games. Massive Portal 2 player me. I play a lot of Community Chambers with nearly 1700 hours of Portal 2 alone. But games like Talos, Witness, Turing Test, they're all pretty freaking good. Pretty freaking good puzzles. Puzzle games. Yeah, Portal 2, man. The cake will forever be a lie. So I can do that, but then I haven't got enough mirrors to reflect it back. So, to sort of basically bring people up to speed with what's going on here. You've got this column here in the middle, and this needs to receive a yellow light to activate these two little beam things here. So we can achieve that by doing that and putting the green one there. So that gives us our green light there. Now, the issue is these little portable ones have a very limited range. And to get to complete the puzzle, I've got to activate this, this, and this with my resources, which is the bit that's like throwing me out at the minute, because I can activate two, but I need to get a yellow light here. So I've got to point a green light in this direction at some point, but then that detracts from the green at the top. So, yeah, it's, that's interesting, actually. I wonder if I could use something like this. So, that sits at an angle. That's just going to completely wreck everything. Even more than it's wrecking my brain right now. Yeah, were you playing Resi 2 tonight, subs? Did you nail down that PB? Did you beat your 1 minute 10:32, I think? Was that your PB? I know I've watched back your stream from last night, earlier today. I think I remember you said that like the last two runs you'd literally done almost identical times, which is quite mad. So we'll put that there. But that doesn't help us because then we lose that. So these things allow us to split the light. But we'd have to use the 45 degree mirror then to do that. Nice. I need to do some more resi runs, man. It's been a long while. But first, before I do any sort of resi runs, I need to actually play the remake now that I bought it. I'm quite looking forward to playing that real soon. So, yeah, this is baffling. It's nice. I'm quite looking forward to it as well because the fact that I'm completely blind. I have not watched. I've been sort of like keeping myself restrained, so I've not watched anything at all from like any content from anybody, which is why I'm really looking forward to playing it even more. So I don't know how to get this. Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be plenty of moments. And it's been a while since I played a game which absolutely scared the crap out of me as well, so that's always a bonus. Come watch streamer scare the crap out of himself. Oh, jeez. Alright, I'm going to use a couple of hints here because... Alright, so three of the items go there. I've only got one, two, three. Alright, so... Choose our last hint slot. So it's something that's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright, so we've got 5 of the positions. So this music's starting to drive me a little bit crazy. Have you, I shouldn't think you've cracked open Alien Isolation yet, have you, subs? All right, so I stick by my fact that I think that's got to... It was like the day I bought my PlayStation 4 off eBay, that was the first thing I did. As soon as I bought it, I ordered Alien Isolation because I'm a massive fan of the franchise, and it's nice to have an alien game which is more oriented around like the original movie. I found a lot of the alien games were always geared around more like the second of, like, you're the Marines and you're going in somewhere and you're going to blow stuff up and kill stuff, whereas Alien Isolation is a lot more like the survival horror kind of thing, which is I was really excited for. It's an absolutely fantastic game in my opinion. See, even if I was to use, like... Yeah, it's just... I'm really gutted, though, that there's not going to be a sequel. That Sega's not got the budget for a sequel. It's a real shame. Was there and that was there. No, I don't think that would make too much of a difference. I don't know. I think they've pretty much written it off, which is a real shame. You'd love an alien game where you're a little, the evil android trying to convince a human to go pick up the alien. Yeah, that'd be good. I think in the... I never played the survival mode on Alien Isolation. I just played like the campaign. But I'm pretty sure there's like... in the survival mode, there's some DLCs where you can actually play as some of the... like the androids, and I'm not sure whether you're trying to help or hinder Ripley. Like I say, I never actually played any of the DLC because I played so much campaign to platinum the game. I was kind of a little bit burnt out by the end of it. Why would I want that there? But I need something there. This game is frying my brain. Hold on a sec. Hold on a sec. But where have I got a rip? I thought I was onto something there. So that would need to be more over here. But I need a green there. Dude, seriously. Can't do that because that blocks light, so I don't see what I would want to put here. It makes no sense. So that all but works, but there's like that one key point which is missed. It doesn't particularly help that you only get like a limited number of like hints in this as well. And I also realize that like the majority of my things where I position them aren't even in positions where, see, I don't think the red one does anything different or anything else than that. I don't think that would make sense. I'm about to kill on the nose of this game. So we could do that and that. But we would need it there. But that just creates like a little closed loop that I really can't use anything else on. That obviously blocks that. I don't see what I would want to put there. That blocks that, so that's not helpful at all. So what if we did this? And then no, that's not gonna help. And it gives us that. And we can do, again, we can do that, but we don't have anything. We don't have anything hitting this. If I had to hazard a guess, right? I say we need a red, angled off there to up to there. Because that'll give us that and that. Then we can bring this one. I think that's it. Is that it? No. Thought for a moment I was onto something. I mean, we have all our bases covered. How would we reflect a green one down to here? Well, I have no idea. We're just hopelessly trying to frickin' stumble our way through this one. I may call it a night for this for tonight. We're not really making much progress. So, how long we got left? We got about another hour or so. Complete 20 levels by finding all collectibles. That's something alright. Right, so let's have a look. What else have we got? Let's see. We could go for a resi run. We've not done a resi run in a while. I keep threatening I'm going to play it again. Achievement unlocked. Wise man. Why is my achievements popping up now I've quit the game? That makes no sense. Alright, let's update stuff here. See how rusty we actually are. Yeah, it's the only scenario I know, subs. So,